In this Iqraa 50 session, we will discuss how to achieve 50% marks in JEE Advanced with respect to 2016 Maths Paper 1. The discussion is presented by Tanveer, Director of Iqraa Edusolutions. He has done his B.Tech from IIT Bombay and MS from University of Wisconsin Madison, USA. Many a times, a student deserving 50% marks in an examination environment failed to perform up to the potential. Why? Here we would discuss why it happens and how can one perform up to his potential. In order to perform up to his potential, one must attempt the paper under proper action plan. One should develop the ability to scan the paper and select appropriate questions to begin with. He should be able to find out two things. First, the level of difficulty of the question, and second, how fast the problem could be solved. Suppose there are three questions and we need to identify which question to start with. Now let's see the level of difficulty of the questions, and we see here that question number 1 and question number 2 are relatively easy. Now let's see the time each will take, and we see here that question number 2 will probably take lesser time, so this is the best question to start with. Now let's have a quick review of Maths Paper 1 2016. And we see that the first two sections, they have negative marking, but the last section, integer type section, has no negative marking. The paper was of 62 marks, and to get 50% marks, we need to answer 10 questions, just 10 questions out of the 18 questions. But considering unfavorable conditions, it's possible that you may make a mistake, so target one question extra, so target total 11 questions. And the most important thing is, which 11 questions? Let's see some don'ts. Don't attempt section 2 multiple correct questions in the beginning because they carried -2 marks for the wrong answer. And each question was equivalent to 4 questions because all the 4 options need to be evaluated for full marks, and each option evaluation was as lengthy as a separate individual question. There are 3 criteria to select the questions. The first criteria is to start with the questions that has no negative marking, and here we had integer type questions with no negative marking. And the second criteria is to know your strength, look into yourself and find out which topics you have command over. And the third criteria is to know the scoring topics, vectors, 3D, complex numbers, circles, conic sections, matrices and determinants, limits, continued differentiability. These are the scoring topics. However, these topics are normally not scoring, permutation and combination and probability. Because these involves a number of cases and you might miss one case and make a wrong answer. However, the Bayes theorem in probability is highly scoring because it involves direct application of the formula. So let's start achieving our target of 50%. We have 1 hour and total 11 questions to be attempted. So approximately 6 minutes for each question if we take some time from chemistry section. Don't panic and be confident. You have enough time. Do all the calculations carefully and confidently, and you have no room for a single silly mistake. Start with integer type questions that has no negative marking and skip the questions that are not of your brain. There are 5 questions in the integer type section, and let's see the level of difficulty of each question. And we see here that the limit question is relatively easy. Let's see the time each will take, and here we again see that the limit question will take lesser time. So this is the best question to start with. Let's start the journey with the limit question as it involves no major numerical calculations. In this question, we need to find out the value of alpha and beta so that the limit x tends to 0, x square sin beta x upon alpha x minus sin x is equal to 1. Here we see that in the numerator, we have 3 zeros. So in the denominator also, we need to have 3 zeros so that we have a finite limit. So here, sine of beta x can be approximated as beta x. So we get here x cube in the numerator, and also we need x cube in the denominator. And to get x cube in the denominator, put the series of sin x as x minus x cube by factor 3. Thus we get the term x cube in the denominator. Now to get only x cube term in the denominator, the first term should be 0. So
alpha should be equal to 1. So we get 6 beta x cube upon s cube, the limit is equal to 1. So beta is equal to 1 by 6. And thus we get 6 alpha plus beta is equal to 7. Now what next? So let's find out the question that is relatively easy and also takes less time. So here we see that binomial theorem, it will take lesser time. So let's go for the binomial theorem problem. And the problem says that we have 1 plus x whole square plus 1 plus x whole cube up to 1 plus x power 49 plus 1 plus mx to power 50. And we need to find the n, so that coefficient of x square is equal to 3n plus 1, 51 c3. For smallest integer m, looks like it has many calculations. But we have 6 minutes for this question and there is no negative marking. And also it can be simplified by using GP. Here we see that the first 48 terms form a GP with the first term 1 plus x whole square and common ratio as 1 plus x. So we need to find out the coefficient of x square in the first 48 terms as sum of GP and the last term. So we need the coefficient of x square in these two terms, which is equivalent to the coefficient of x cube in this term and coefficient of x square in the last term. So here we see that this term has no x cube. So we need coefficient of x cube in 1 plus x to the power whole 50 and coefficient of x square in 1 plus mx to the power whole 50. So we need 50 c3 and 50 c2 m square, which is equal to 3n plus 1, 51 c3, which is given. And on solving, we get this equation, m square is equal to 51 n plus 1. And by trial and error, we find that for the least value of m is equal to 16, we get n is equal to 5. Now, what next problem should we attempt? From our analysis, we see here that the complex number problem is relatively easy and also it would take lesser time. So let's start with the complex number problem. In this problem, z is given as minus 1 plus iota root 3 by 2. And a 2 by 2 matrix P is given where R and S belongs to the integer 1, 2 and 3. And we need to find out the number of ordered pairs R, S, so that P square is equal to minus I. And this could be a good scoring problem because we see here that z is equal to omega, the complex cube root of unity. So we can apply the properties of omega, that is omega cube is equal to 1, omega to the power 4 is equal to omega, omega to the power 5 is omega square, omega to the power 6 is equal to 1, and so on. Also, there is a small 2 by 2 matrix to be evaluated. And to get P square, we need to multiply the two matrices and we get here P square. Now, if this P square is equal to minus I, then this should be equal to minus 1 and this should be equal to 0. Now, this combination is equal to 0 only when R is equal to odd, that is 1 or 3. Now, this term is equal to minus 1 and omega to the power 4 is equal to omega. So we get here omega to the power 2r plus omega to the power s is equal to minus 1. And for r equal to 1 and s equal to 1, we get omega square plus omega equal to minus 1, and which is true. And besides this, we have no solution because r cannot be 3 as omega to the power 6 is equal to 1. Also, s cannot be 2 because omega square plus omega square is not equal to minus 1. And s also cannot be equal to 3 because omega to the power cube becomes 1. So we have only one solution, r equal to 1 and s equal to 1. So far, we have got 9 marks. Now, from our question set, we see here the determinants problem is relatively easy and less time consuming. So let's start with the determinants problem. In this determinant problem, it is required to find out the distinct values of x so that the value of determinant is equal to 10. And the easiest way to solve is to get two zeros in any column, and here we get two zeros in the second column. Now we get this equation, and by putting x cube is equal to t, we get a quadratic equation, and we solve the quadratic equation, we get x cube is equal to minus 1 and 10 by 12. So we get here two distinct values of real x. Now let's solve the last functions and integration problem. The question says that find x in 0 to 1 so that the function on LHS intersects with the function on RHS. It is a problem of point of intersection of two curves. Let the function on LHS be f of x and the function on RHS be g of x. Instead of actually evaluating, let's solve it graphically. Now first check slope of the function, and we see here that f dash x is equal to x square upon 1 plus x to the power 4. So we can see here that f dash x is always positive. So we can see f of x is always increasing. Now let's find the upper and lower limit of the function. We see here f of 0 becomes 0 and t square upon 1 plus t4 is greater than 0 and less than t square in the interval 0 to 1. So it is between 0 and 1. So we can see that the function lies between 0 and 1. So now here we have three possibilities. In the first possibility, we see here that f of x lies between 0 and less than 1 and f of x is increasing, while g of x lies between minus 1 and plus 1. So fx cuts g of x at 3 points. In the second possibility, the fx cuts gx at 1 point and still f of x is increasing. And in the third possibility also, we have 1 point of intersection. Now we see which is our case. So we need to double differentiate. On checking f double dash x, we find that f double dash x is always greater than 0 for x in the interval 0 to 1. So second possibility is correct, where the function is concave up, and so we have only one solution in 0 to 1 interval. Thus we finish integer type section and we have secured 15 marks. Now let's look for a suitable question in single correct section. There are 5 questions in the single correct section, and this section carried negative marking, so we need to be very careful in selecting the question to start with. Now let's see the level of difficulty and the time taken for each question. And when we evaluate, we see here that the quadratic equation with the trigonometric roots, it is relatively easy, and also it would take less time. So let's start with the quadratic equation problem. There are two quadratic equations. This is the first equation with roots alpha 1 and beta 1, and alpha 1 is greater than beta 1. Similarly, this is the second equation and alpha 2 is greater than beta 2 is given. Now let's solve the first equation, and we get the roots here as sec theta plus minus tan theta. It is given that alpha 1 is greater than beta 1. So graphically we see here that in the interval sec theta minus tan theta is greater than sec theta plus tan theta. So alpha 1 is sec theta minus tan theta. Similarly for the second equation, we get the roots here minus tan theta plus minus sec theta, and proceeding as before, we get here beta 2 is equal to minus tan theta minus sec theta. And thus alpha 1 plus beta 2 becomes minus 2 tan theta, which was required to be evaluated. So far we have scored 18 marks. Now let's look for the highly scoring problem, and we see here that the Bayes theorem problem is relatively easy and also less time consuming. So now let's start with this problem. The problem says that the computer factory has two plants, T1 and T2. T1 produces 20% computers, T2 produces 80% computers, and the factory produces 7% defective computers. And the probability that T1 produces a defective computer is 10 times the probability that T2 produces defective computer. Now it is given that a computer randomly selected was not defective, and we need to find out the probability that it was produced by T2. Using this given relation and the formula for the probability of an event, we find out that the probability of T2 producing a defective computer is 1 by 40. Now using the Bayes theorem formula and the given and calculated results, we found out the probability that T2 produced the computer given that it was not defective is 78 by 93. Now the next best scoring problem is the inequality problem in terms of the level of difficulty and the time it will take. The question says that find the least value of alpha for which this expression is greater than or equal to 1 for all positive x. When we simplify, we get this cubic expression. Let fx be this cubic expression, and we need to find beta so that f dash beta equal to 0, and when we simplify, we get here beta equal to plus minus 1 by root 12 alpha. Now let's plot the function, and we see here that the function is minimum at beta 1 for positive x. Now for this function to be greater than or equal to 0 for all positive x, we need to have f of beta 1 greater than or equal to 0, and on simplifying we get here alpha greater than or equal to 1 by 27. So the minimum value of alpha is 1 by 27. The probability problem appears difficult, but in terms of time, it appears good to start with. A debate team of 4 members is to be selected from 6 girls and 4 boys, and also one captain needs to be selected so that there is at most one boy. So here we have 2 cases, 0 boy and 1 boy. In 0 boy case, we select all the 4 girls, and in the 1 boy case, we select 1 boy and 3 girls. And one captain can be selected from the 4 members in 4 ways. So this is the total ways, which is equal to 380. Now let's solve the last trigonometric equation problem. It says find the sum of the distinct solutions of this equation in the interval minus pi to pi. When we simplify this equation, we get cos x minus pi by 3 is equal to cos 2x. Now this is true in the first and fourth quadrant. So where here we have 4 particular solutions. When we simplify here, we get 4 solutions. And when we add these 4 solutions, we get here summation of x is equal to 0. So far, we have scored 30 marks. Now let's have a look at the multiple character section. Here we have 8 questions. Now let's examine the problems in terms of level of difficulty and the time taken for each problem. We see here that the solution of triangles, this problem appears easy, but when we examine other problems, we see here that the differential equation and the limit problem, it is taking less time. So let's start with this problem. The problem says that a function f of x such that f dash x is equal to 2 minus fx upon x and f of 1 is not equal to 1. When you simplify this differential equation, we get here dy by dx plus 1 by xy is equal to 2, which is a linear equation dy by dx plus py is equal to q. And the integrating factor is x. So the solution of the equation is yx is equal to x square plus c. And it is given that f of 1 is not equal to 1. So we get here c not equal to 0. So the function f of x is x plus c by x. Now let's evaluate the first option, limit x tend to 0 from the positive side, f dash 1 by x equal to 1. What is f dash 1 by x? Now put x equal to 1 by x in the original equation and we get here this relation. And on simplifying, we get here f dash 1 by x equal to 2 minus x f of 1 by x. Now f of x is equal to x plus c by x. So f of 1 by x is 1 by x plus cx. Putting this value, we get here f dash 1 by x equal to 1 minus cx square. So limit x tends to 0 from the positive side, f dash 1 by x becomes 1. And so thus the option A is correct. Now let's evaluate the second option, limit x tends to 0 from the positive side, x f of 1 by x equal to 2. We have f of x is equal to x plus c by x. So f of 1 by x is 1 by x plus cx. So we have x into f of 1 by x is equal to 1 plus cx square. So when we put the limit, we get here 1. So option B is incorrect. Now let's see option C, limit x tends to 0 from the positive side, x square f dash x equal to 0. We have f of x is equal to x plus c by x. It means f dash x is equal to 1 minus cx square. So when we see x square f dash x, we get x square minus c. So when you put the limit, we get here minus c, and which is not equal to 0 because c was not equal to 0. So the option C is incorrect. Now let's evaluate the last option, which says that mod of f of x is less than or equal to 2 for all x in interval 0 to 2. We have f of x is equal to x plus cx. So for all positive x, we have arithmetic mean is greater than or equal to geometric mean. So from this, we have x plus c by x is greater than or equal to 2 root c. That is, f of x is greater than or equal to 2 root c, where c is any non-zero number. So we see here that option D is also not correct.
And thus, with the proper strategic planning, we were able to achieve 50% marks.